Hello, I'm Chandler Britt. Today, I will be giving my informative speech for Public Speaking Communication 231. This is my audience, Janine Britt, Courtney Britt, and Greg Britt, my family. Today, we'll be discussing depression and anxiety. Depression is not simple. Depression is a very serious and controversial issue relevant in today's society. Depression has many different stages and names, which can easily escalate to far worse problems. If depression lasts more than 2 years, it is called persistent depressive disorder, a type of depression which changes between extreme high is called bipolar depression. There are many more types of depression, but they are less common. Depression does not only affect adults. Depression affects, or can affect, everyone, elderly and children alike. Previously, depression in children was regarded as if it was non-existent or not important to research into. Recently, this has changed. Childhood depression, which is also called pediatric depression, is now recognized as a serious disorder. This is very good, in fact, because identification of a problem is one of the first steps in solving the problem. Anxiety and depression walk hand in hand. More commonly than not, when someone has anxiety, they are also diagnosed with depression. Anxiety hinders almost every aspect of your body. You become unsure of yourself. You become nervous, start to question yourself, which can affect you both physically, mentally, and emotionally. If you're giving a speech or playing a game of football, you may notice that anxiety is often apparent in your voice, the way you talk. It may make you sound like you have stage fright. Or it could affect you in playing football, so you miss the game-winning catch because you were afraid of missing the ball and letting your team down. People generally think of anxiety and depression as two totally different problems. Well, they are not. These are both serious issues that need to be addressed and fixed now. So, how do we deal with this, and what if we don't? Well, guys, quite simply, the first step is to admit you have a problem, and then seek help from a professional. If you do not accept this, then when you do get help from a therapist or a psychologist or psychiatric institution, you will be very nervous and self-conscious, and you won't fully be able to heal from your visits there. But by being comfortable with your therapist, this is very important to the success of the treatment. A trained professional can guide you to heal on your own without the use of medication or products like that. If you do not seek help from a professional, then you can ruin bonds with your friends and family. And honestly, guys, you could do the unthinkable. You could harm yourself or others. This is not something we want. So, in conclusion, depression is a real tough issue that we all can help fix. A simple smile or friendly hello can help change somebody's day. So, be kind and be aware. Depression is there. Is there any questions, comments?
Question. Is there any particular group of people that these disorders are more likely to occur in?
Well, honestly, depression can affect everybody. There are no set standards to who it's going to affect. So, what we have to do is early diagnosis. If you feel like you can't handle something, you can't handle a specific set of circumstances, seek help. talk to somebody. It may save your life. It may change your life for the better. All right, guys. Thank you for listening. And have a good night.